Okay, everybody, let's start today's class. Can you turn off the light in the front? So today's topic is nanotech, national project. Today's video, we are going to talk about education, educational program. So-called human resource development program, nanotech human resource development program, is an educational program for this national project. And another one is a core facility. If you went to a nano exhibition last month, you saw many booths. And this is one very big booth for education project. And another big booth for our core facility. Okay, let's see this GDP of many several countries in the world. So which country has the highest GDP? Which one? Right now. Actually, from this table, Norway. Norway has highest GDP in the world. 1970, Norway has about 3,000 per person. 3,289 US dollars. Right now, is 71. 5 years ago, 71,000. Now, 2011, I think that they have more than 80,000 per person. It's this country is the richest in the world. Why Norway has so high GDP? What? Can you say again? I don't understand. Say again.
Low population.
Low
population.
Not
so many people living there. There are some natural resources.
Yeah, the population for Norway, around next table. We can see from here. Norway has population 4,900,000. Taiwan has almost 23 million. But they have around 5 million. But why they have so high GDP?
Oil.
Yeah, oil. Yeah, they have a lot of oil. Yeah, just like Saudi Arabia or UAE or United Arabia Emirates or UAE in Middle East. Norway is the richest country in the world because they have oil. They have many natural resources. The blue color over here is means 1970, the number one GDP in the world. In 1970, around 40 years ago, USA GDP is about 4,878. 40 years ago, Taiwan is only 391 US dollars. Less than 10%. Less than 10% of USA. And right now, not now, 5 years ago, 2006, Norway is 71,000 US dollars. United States, 43,000. Japan, 34,000 US dollars. And Taiwan, 5 years ago, around 15,000 per person. Right now, around 18 or 19,000 US dollars. Right now, probably. About 18 or 19,000. So, for the last 10 years, Norway has the highest GDP in the world.
we can see from this chart, the red color, I think around 1980, they discovered some oil around the coast, I think. They have a lot of oil. They made a lot of money from oil. And the yellow color, United States. United States is a well-developed country. So the growth rate for GDP is very stable. It's not like jumping around. So maybe every year, 3%, 5%, maybe 10% increase every year. So we can see from here, actually, these three countries very similar. Norway, they have oil and only 5 million population. Taiwan, blue color, we have 23 million. But the GDP per country almost the same. And Finland, Finland about 5 million 200,000. But Finland has a higher GDP. I think from here, Finland about two times, 39,000 US dollars compared to Taiwan 5 years ago. Why Finland? Finland has no oil. Why Finland was so high last few years? Why? Any how Finland make money? There is one company, Nokia, right? Do you remember Nokia? Nokia was number one mobile phone country company. The market share around more than 30%. Or even 40% several years ago. Yeah, so Finland, they have a very good, very high tech for mobile phone or wireless technology. So because of Nokia, Finland has so high GDP. Actually, for a small country, you need either you have natural resource, like South Africa, maybe they have gold, they have diamond, they have many natural resource. Or like Norway, they have oil, they have natural gas. Or just like Soviet Union, they have also oil and natural gas. And the United States, they have everything. Oil, maybe coal or steel or many natural resources. And Japan very similar to Taiwan. Japan has no natural resource. More than 90% of natural resources come from import or from foreign country, just like Taiwan. Taiwan we have very few or very little natural resource. Okay, so actually Taiwan try to develop our own technology. So we have semiconductor technology and also display, as I mentioned last few weeks. So there's one national project called a nanotech national project. We start from 2003. The first phase, 6 years. 2003, 2004, 2005, and 6 years total, first phase. Now we are in our second phase from 2009 and the last year 2010 and this year 2011. So from this national project, there are four different research or different sub project. The first one is a national industry utilization. It's a Department of Economics develop many many person for this part, and they spend two-thirds of the budget of this budget of this program for they try to have some product like a clothes or like a semiconductor etc. Then the other three part we are going to see in the film today co-facility and education. And another one is academic excellence research. Taiwan government give many professors a lot of money to do some high, very advanced project. So this one is for education, and this one is for co-facility. Why we need a co-facility? In Taiwan, there are nine university or research center has a co-facility. Because co-facility, you need a lot of space, and you need a lot of money to buy equipment or fabrication facility. So you can see later in the film, you can see some electronic microscope. It cost millions. Millions US dollars, very expensive microscope. Okay, so actually I'm also doing one of this education project. So the goal for this education project is there are several goals. The first one is to promote lifelong learning for nanotech education and promote popularization and upgrade higher professional education and the so-called K-12 education. I ask you this question, right? What's a K? K-12. From kindergarten to 12th grade. That means for young kids. And for higher education, that means university and graduate school. Okay, so this is the goal for nanotech education project. For the first phase, 2003 up to 2008, education project is supervised by Ministry of Education. There is one program office, and there are several regional center for K-12. Five regional center, and another five regional center for advanced nanotech education. This part for university and graduate school. And for this part, for the first northern Taiwan, the center is in this university. I'm in charge of this part. And another professor in this university, he is handling a K-12 education project. So for this university, National Taiwan University, we have two projects. One is for higher education, one is for K-12. And the other four universities, Tsinghua University, in Taichung, there's Zhongxin University, and Southern Taiwan, Chenggong University, and Eastern Taiwan, Donghua University. So there are actually five universities, and each university has two projects. And another one for e-learning, so-called exchange platform, that's the website. Okay, so here is Taiwan. We are in Taipei, NTU. So I'm in charge of one of these national projects for advanced education. The other Professor Song, he's handling the K-12. And Tsinghua University along here, Central Taiwan, Zhongxin University, and Southern Taiwan, Chenggong University, and Eastern Taiwan， 东华 University， around here， So later you are going to see many many high school teachers， Miss Zhang and Miss Ma， these two lady teacher， they are from Hualien， Jian Junior High School， and another one primary school， Miss Liu， you are going to see her later， and another one professor CKD， and another professor in this institute， Professor Liu， and another professor from Academia Sinica， Professor Li， and one professor from Academia Sinica， Professor Wu， he is the head of this national project for first phase， and Professor Chen， he has a two or three very expensive electronic microscope. He is a professor in this university also. And later you are going to see Miss Su, Dr. Su. He is a head of, he is a director of Nano Center of Yichui. So yeah, maybe we can see the video first.
<音>这里是花莲县的原住民教会部落里的老人们专心地听着詹贤元老师以及吉安国中的同学们带领他们进入奈米的新世界。来哦来哦，花莲优质白米哦！来哦来哦，来买我的雕刻技纳米哦！
老板，纳米的米一包怎么卖啊？
小哥啊，看你长得可爱乖巧，天资聪颖，运巧美，脸上发出一股无穷的魅力。21世纪的奈米新科技走进了后山原住民的部落。 这一切多亏了詹贤元老师，他同时也是奈米国家行计划培训的种子教师。因为这群种子教师，奈米这个尖端科技才得以散播到台湾的各个角落。
这个图片啊，可以让大家欣赏。还有我们现在又研发一种，用就是类似壁虎脚掌的手套，然后只要以后我们套住那个手套啊。
就可以像这只猪一样这样攀岩走，比较快，我们不是人。演话剧、还举办有奖征答，为了让活动成功，詹贤元想了很多点子。我们的话，我们怕啥呀？哎，我们请那边的啊，牧师一直想要那个奖，你们都没有给那个，我们师傅来拿。哎，牧师哪一个答案呢？
介绍过程中都请牧师或长老来帮我们翻译，用母语来翻译，这会使呢这个呢我们的推展上呢会更加成功。
像詹贤元这样积极的奈米种子教师，全国各地有1000多位，这个数字是其他先进国家都难望其项背的。
有这样的一个宣导的时候，让这些阿公阿嬷最起码哎什么叫奈米产品了解一些，能够辨识一些，那这是社会的一个帮助。 目前各国都积极投入研发奈米科技，我国预估在西元2012年，奈米科技的产值就将达到1兆元的目标。而2014年全球奈米产业的年产值更将突破新台币80兆，预计在10年到15年之后，全球产业将出现新一波的激烈竞争。
我们假想一个国家，假如它最基础的研究人力是在硕士班这个等级的时候。 那我们当时在规划团队里面问一个问题：10年之后的硕士班研究生现在在哪里？那个答案很简单的，现在的小学6年级。那么如果我们问说，那么25年之后的硕士班研究生现在在哪里？答案是快要生出来。所以我们当时的开玩笑的说法说，那么说不定我们应该推动奈米胎教的。
什么是奈米？奈米其实是一种非常小的长度单位，一奈米就是一公尺的十亿分之一。例如以地球为基准，十亿分之一就相当于地球上的一颗小弹珠。大自然中莲花的叶子表面就布满了一奈米直径大小的凸起物，这使得水珠不但不易附着在莲叶上，还能带走叶面上的尘埃。莲叶出污泥而不染的秘密，其实就是奈米的原理。科学普及教育做得越成功，整体国力便更能向上提升。事实上，我国从2003年就开始推动国家型的奈米人才培育计划，一方面做前瞻人才培育，一方面做科普的传承。
我觉得其实就是深入浅出。对，其实很多科技的东西不是小朋友不懂，而是你用什么方式去教小朋友。
除了有种子老师出版了科普的套书外，其他有的发展出中英日文对照的线上奈米词典，也有老师自制的卡通在国际间被翻成多国语言受到欢迎，还有像是漫画、闯关游戏等等。
哇哦，这就是未来世界啊！未来的世界好漂亮哦。
对啊，墙壁就像会发光似的，
看，不只是房子，连车子也像会发光般的干净呢。
在国外，你也许有一些国家他们的奈米科技非常的先进，可是他们从来没有人愿意花时间尝试着去写一个很有系统的一套科普的教材。所以这套书事实上像美国的Ohio State University 他们已经跟我们接洽，说看我们可以把这套书让他们翻译成英文，作为他们大学一二年级的通识教材。
事实上，奈米科技是未来的核心科技。由于实体尺寸的缩小以及物质的性质，在奈米尺寸下将会产生新的特性和现象，因此人类生活将因为奈米技术而产生惊人变革。无论科技发展、医学制药、各行各业乃至日常生活，都离不开奈米，因此更显这项人才培育计划的重要。
我们从所有的教育分析来看，认为一个科技如果真的一个国家的科技要做得好的话，那么要像金字塔一样，那么底部要又深又广，那么它的高度才可以真正的拔尖。
面对奈米这项即将风起云涌的新兴科技产业，我国早已备战，而人才培育计划将是我国未来制胜的关键。
所以才认为说我们应该从K12就开始。那所谓 K12 其实是这个美国的用了一个名词啦， K 代表的是幼稚园 Kindergarten， 那12就是12年级，也就是我们这里的高三，所以它指的就是整个中小学的这一串这样。
台大应力所的所长刘佩玲负责政府这项奈米教育的培训计划，在没有任何潜力可循的情况下，这项计划却以惊人的效果成长。
那么这些老师当初找来之后，因为大家都不晓得奈米是什么，所以也非常的恐慌。那么我们怎么开始呢？其实也没有任何的教科书，什么都没有，国外也没有，所以就找了国内这个奈米科技的一些相关的专家，就开始来给他们上课。
当时有非常多的大学的老师，中研院的这个院士，甚至我们工研院的很多所长、副所长都亲自来授课，把这样的知识传递给我们的这些种子老师们。
从自然科老师到社会科，甚至美术、体育各科老师都逐渐主动参与计划，在没有酬劳、牺牲假日的情况下参与计划进修，虽然辛苦，却又为自己、为学生感到骄傲。
平常会就蛮喜欢去听一些演讲活动的，所以我觉得他如果礼拜天，然后这些科技如果他安排的这些教授演讲还蛮精彩的，我觉得基本上对我而言不算是一个负担了。
最大难处是归我了啦，因为我的 baby 小嘛，所以我先生非常的生气，他说你再赖米下去的话哈，真是蛮为难的啊。不过就是因为呢，我们觉得学校需要推动这样的教育，我们首先老师要自我进修，要先知道才能够带领学生， 所以呢也就是这样走下去。
我觉得那是一个这样的东西，在我感觉不算是职业，是一种置业。那我觉得其实做得很高兴，真的，那一定是浪费额外的时间啦。对，但是又觉得说看着小朋友的那么高兴，说实在蛮欣慰的。你们觉得呢？你们觉得好不好玩？听不听得懂？
这个想不到会那么成功哦！半年这些老师就学到了新的知识，而且可以把它转化成中小学生可以吸收的，所以就把这个范围就扩大了。所以在这个计划里面呢，就开始成立一个计划办公室。
为了服务更多的教师，这个跨部会的人才培育计划除了成立全国性的办公室，并在全国各地设置了五个中心，分别在北部的台大、中北部的清华大学、中部的中兴大学、南部的成大及东部的东华大学。这五个中心也各自召集附近的大学来做伙伴学校，此外并在所负责的区域寻找中小学来配合。这项奈米人才培育计划可说是成果丰硕。
在国外做这个人才培育，我问他们说你们有多少老师参与你们这个计划，他大概说也许就是20个吧。我们执行了3年下来，我们已经有100多个中小学参与。那参与我们这个活动的教师，中小学教师已经有1900多位。所以我们每次在跟国外做国际交流的时候，一提出这种数据，他们马上就投降了。
十年树木，百年树人。过去3年，政府投入了1亿4000万的经费。下一个3年，政府准备投入2亿4000万，投入经费也投入国家精英。为了决战明天，这个奈米人才培育计划已然看到成效。
人才是一个长期的培育，我们希望看到我们整体的学术卓越的架构，那么跟整体的这个所谓的跨领域的整合，这部分其实还蛮成功的。今天不投资，明天是会后悔的。
根据调查，我国在成长竞争力的排名上为全球第4，在科技竞争力的表现上则居全球第2名。由于人才培育必须兼顾科普与精英，以长期的眼光来看，在未来奈米科技的新战场上，我国似乎已赢得先机。这里是台大凝态中心，地下室有一间神秘的实验室，里头藏了一个全台湾最贵的宝贝。
这台机器在亚洲是第一台，全世界是第5台，具有类似功能的超高解析度的电子显微镜。所以呢，因为它有这么它高的功能，譬如说它的解析度可以到0.2纳米。
奈米科技近年来受到相当的瞩目，主要就是因为显微量测仪器的进步，传统光学显微镜无法察知的种种现象，现在都因为这部神秘武器让人类进入了奈米世界。
它可以对奈米材料在这个0.2纳米解析度下进行化学成分的分析，所以它是一个非常尖端的一种技术。
一流的仪器只有专家中的专家足以操控。这间实验室全台湾目前只有8个研究员可以实际操作，甚至连实验室都是量身打造以维持仪器的高解析度。
它的造价当然是相当的昂贵，它的市价呢差不多是在300万美元左右。我们的实验室的温度、湿度的变化，还有这个电磁波的杂讯跟噪音，都要控制到一个最低最低的程度。
用冷却板代替冷气机，减少室内空气的大幅流动，吸音墙则是用来隔绝噪音。另外，为了杜绝磁性，就连椅子也完全使用木头卡榫，一根铁钉都不能有。实验进行时也严禁说话。
这是全台湾第一间实验室根据这种构想之下建制的一个电子显微镜的实验室，是算是一个非常 安静非常干净的一个实验室。
事实上，国科会主导的奈米国家型计划中共建制了9项核心设施，分别位在台大、中研院、工研院、清大、交大、中台湾的中正大学、南台湾的成大、中山大学以及东部的东华大学，彼此各自独立却又互相连结，形成了资源共享的知识化网络。
那现在的我们的做法是说，把这些放在各个大学来，有各个大学的中心来控管。那它有一个最重要的作用，就是它第一个它要用网络都连在一起，第二个它必须要有开放，它必须要让任何想用的人都可以申请。这个当然也是网络发达带来的一个便利，使得这个事情可以现在用这个最有效率的方法来达成资源共享。
这项计划的设置就是要让台湾在全球奈米科技的竞争中建立创新领导的地位。
政府觉得应该在这个方面做足够的投资，来鼓励台湾在这个方面将来的奈米科技产业的发展里面能够有占有一席之地，在国际上能够有相当的一些成就。所以每一年这些中心大概都是差不多将近5000万台币。
工欲善其事，必先利其器。第一步就是要建制世界级的奈研发环境。进入中研院的无尘室之前，要先确保不会带进一根头发、一粒沙子。
这个是我们中研院核心设施的这个无尘室，这个里面呢有很多比较贵重的仪器。那因为要在无尘室，原因之一就是说，因为有很多的测量里面，当然我们希望减少很多空气里面的杂质。那这一台机器是当然是相当的昂贵哈，大概要7000多万的台币哈。你手震动一下，你呼吸一口气，你这呼吸一口气的这个空气的震动是远大概超过1000倍奈米的尺寸。
事实上，台湾半导体产业的技术居于世界的领导地位，而这正是发展奈米科技的最大优势。为了保持领先地位，政府投入了大量的财力物力，因为奈米科技背后创造出的价值是无可计量的。
当把这个研究这个东西的尺度越来越小，说到奈米的时候，大家发觉我们做的东西好像都是有相关联的，物理、化学、材料、电机、生意各方面的，大家就觉得哇，我们彼此之间都很需要彼此之间的一些专长。
金就是黄金的那个黄金，可是它到奈米尺寸它变成红金，发现它可以吸收近红外线。但是如果是跨领域的话，生物学家他是怎么看这件事情？把奈米金放到癌细胞里面的话，就把癌细胞杀掉了。
工研院的奈米科技中心曾经被誉为是科学家的天堂，这里的研究发展就是为了快速验证测试来自产业界的创意。
那前一阵子很流行的这个奈米水，大家认为说到底这是不是奈米？
奈米水的这个说法可能是一个比较通俗的说辞，那我们应该以尺寸来讲，它是比较小的分子集团水。
这里的研究设备更与民众的生活相结合，例如坊间经常听到的奈米水就可以直接送到这里来检测，辨别真伪。
将这个样品送到这个核磁共振检测，
它可以量那个波峰的宽度，就知道它的那个水分子的集团有多大多小，所以我们就找到一个方法。所以等于说一个功能就是帮忙民众来解决民众常常碰到的一些问题。
国际上一份权威的评估显示，目前投入奈米科技领域的国家居于较领先地位的包括美国、日本、德国及南韩，其次是我国、以色列及新加坡，具有很好的利基并且拥有自己的特色。而英法两国政府投入虽多，但产业化还不够。至于曾被誉为金砖四国中的中国、印度、俄罗斯及加拿大、澳洲等，则都还落后于台湾。
那台湾在这个地方，它被评为说到2012，其实不要到2012，到2010，我们就会进入到主要国家里面。
所以，我们台湾就是要看看我们的强项在什么地方，然后我们着重在把我们的资源跟人力往那个方向去。那这样的话，我们成功的机会就很大。
电子显微镜下的纳米战场正激烈厮杀，而我国粮草兵源充足，人才设施齐备。决战明天，我们信心满满。
Okay, this one professor, Professor Chen, he was a director of Center for Condensed Matter Science. And in the film, you saw a very big electronic microscope. How much he spent for the electronic microscope? $3 million. Oh, okay. You watch the video very carefully. $3 million US dollars. Actually, he came back from Bell Lab, United States. Because he's I had some chance to talk with him. He came back from Bell Lab, and he was a director for 5-6 years. And how many TEM? Electronic microscope is a so-called TEM, tunneling electronic microscope. What's the resolution for that one?
The resolution for 0.2 nanometer.
That's a very high resolution. Actually, there are another two or three smaller one, cheaper one. Yeah, along that. A big TEM in the other room. In that center, the building next to a gymnasium. Yeah, there's one very modern building. That's next to a right next to a gymnasium. There are I think two or three TEM in that center. Okay, so, and another professor, you saw him wear a hat, a mask, and go to a clean room, right? That's one of the core facility. Okay, in the film, it says how many core facility in Taiwan? How many? So-called core facility with a very expensive equipment, just like a TEM. Nine. If you review the video again, nine coal facility in Taiwan. Some just like one in Academic Seneca, and another one in NTU, Center for Condensed Matter, and another one in Hsinchu, Yichui. Okay, so. You can see the slide later. The regional center for K-12 health. Yeah, some goal or some content. We are going to see a game disc later. Some five regional center for advanced nanotech education. Such as curriculum. We have nanotech curriculum. In special nanotech curriculum in this university. I'm in charge for this curriculum. And some non-credit certificate course. We have some science camp. This year, last July, we have 20 students from United States. They came to Taiwan. And next year, we are going to send 20 students to United States, Urbana-Champaign, to have between Taiwan and United States, we have joined a summer camp. One year in Taiwan, 1 year in United States. Some hand-on training. Okay, and some distance learning. In Taiwan, we have last few years, we have so-called distance learning course. One course is so-called. Let me bring the book. We have one course called food, nanotechnology. And about 4 or 5 years ago, I asked four university professor, some professor, around 15 professor, maybe each university around 3 to 5 professor. And we have four university to join the so-called distant learning. One in Yilan, one in Zhongxing, Taichung, Central Taiwan, and another one in Penghu. Do you know Penghu? Maybe I should show. And one in Kim, it's an island, not in Taiwan. One in Penghu, one in Kinmen, Jinmen, in Mandarin. Four university, two university are in Taiwan, and the other two not in Taiwan. So we can have a joint course by using internet, so-called distance learning. Then each professor maybe teach one week, 3 hours. Then after 3 or 4 years, I ask them to write a book. So maybe first year, then second year, they have some modification for the teaching material. Then up this year, this book just come out last September, beginning of this semester, Food Nanotech, but it's in Mandarin, in Chinese, not in English. So actually, we try to have some new course or new teaching method by using a distance or learning. And some workshop or some workshop between the university and industry. Some result for K-12 or some publication activity conference. Okay, here are some example. Do you know what's the lotus effect? What's the lotus effect? If you drop, maybe a water, if you have water droplet on a leaf, or lotus leaf, you can see the drop. It's just like a liquid particle. Can rolling around on the surface of a lotus leaf. And this insect, water strider, it's also a nano effect. Some surface effect, so-called contact angle. Some surface, if you put a water droplet, it's just like this, and just like a sphere or ball. But on some surface, it's just like this. So there are different water surface property. And some disc. For young kid, and one comic book, and two discs. We are going to see these discs later. Nano magic. University nanotech book for fundamental application and the hands-on experiment of nanotechnology. This book is for maybe second year or third year university students. Okay, so I want to show you some picture later. Leno. Okay, last year, last week, we had no class. So I say, we invite you to come to visit my clean room, names and center. So last week, I think we have four students came to visit. I came to my light. Another room? Okay. Yeah, so four students came here, and we have some brief introduction for names, research center. Dr. Cai, he is a research fellow of my in my center. So we have some brief. Yeah. The four students, you two, did you three? And one more. She's not here. Okay. So, Dr. Cai, gave some brief introduction. It's me. Okay, so we went to the other side of this building. We can see some from the window. There is a TV. We can have some brief, briefing over here. We can see from the window, can see what's inside. So the four students. Okay, another picture. So we have some talk over there. Yeah. Okay. So we went to a basement. The entrance of the clean room. Okay, so go into the clean room, the basement. So they're going to put the head and the glove. Okay, the next. Okay, they put the clothes. Over here. Yeah, we took some picture for you. Who is who? Who is this lady? Can you tell? Here is James, right? You are this one or this one?
on the right.
Oh, okay. We'll see. You are the tallest one. Okay. So. So the other lady, this one is who you are? Yeah. Okay. So the next one, so you should go to some air shower room to clean out all the dust. So the standard air standard is class 1000 is the lowest standard we don't need to have a class 100 or 1 or 10 or even higher so the Chinese character says air shower room air shower region so when you open up you should stay inside this air shower room for 20 seconds. Yeah. So you get into the clean room. Okay. Some picture. Some microscope, I think. We have some fabrication facility and measurement facility in this clean room. So So here is a yellow light room. We have different several fabrication facility inside. Very similar to the clean room in Academia Sinica, right? Very similar in the video. In the video, Dr. Li, he also wear a head and a mask and a clothes, and he shows some very expensive, 70 million, 70 million fabrication facility in the video. This is called a yellow room, yellow light room, or yellow room. Some picture. Okay. And last week we went to Penghu. It's a island, a small island off Taiwan, not in this Taiwan. We had some project report. Because we have some project, and every 6 months we should give a project report, says what we did, what we are going to do. So we have some project report, a seminar, workshop in Penghu. It takes around 50 minutes from Taipei, take a flight. We should take an airplane from Taipei to Penghu. I'm one of the project leader. This one is a PI of another K-12. It's another Professor Song in another department. He's handling a K-12 in this university. I'm handling the advanced nanotech education. And he come from Zhanghua, another professor. So we have a booth. So there are several more. Jiao Tong University professor and Department of Physics professor of this university. And this lady professor from Tsinghua University, from Xinzhu. So we have some a disc, a video, some model. And you saw this one in Taipei, nano exhibition, right? Developed by this by the lady professor, Professor Li. He developed this model. This lady professor, he developed some. It's a model for electronic microscope. This is a simple model, but explain the principle, how electronic microscope work. And some teaching kit for young kid, for like a primary school or senior high school or junior high school students. And some nanotech image. I think you saw this image in Taipei Research Center. So it's me, and this gentleman is officer in National Science Council. So we have opening ceremony we have some workshop. I think this one is a governor of Penghu County, this gentleman, and the deputy director of the National Science Council. I think over here, several high level officer. It's me over here. I sit down below. I give some project report. It's me. Several reviewer, several professor. They are reviewing my project. And also another 12 or 13 professors also. We should give some project report for 15-20 minutes and answer the question. Each reviewer should raise a question or two, one or two or three questions. Then I should answer all the questions. The outcome will determine how much money I get next year. Yeah, so some if this reviewer feel maybe one project is not good, maybe they will cut the project budget. So I did some project report around 10 days ago, November 5th and 6th, Saturday and Sunday in Penghu. Okay, another picture. Yeah, we have some group picture. All the reviewers sit over here. And reporter, some report. The PI of some of K-12 project or advanced nanotech project stand over here. I think we have right now 13 or 14 project total. Okay, let's see one video. Then from the video, I'm going to ask you several questions. Okay, before I play this video, I want to show you another news. Did you notice this one news? It's called 龙藏经 in Chinese. Did you notice this news? Yeah, you know, right? Yeah. We talk about a digital archive, the project, national project, digital archive. And a National Palace Museum, they have digitalized. They do a digital image for many real book or very old book. And this this one book, called 龙藏经 in Chinese. I don't know how to call it in English. Dragon Hidden Book or something. So over here, you can see the picture. It's one page. One page of this real book. And all this yellow color board is made of gold. Did you notify this news? Otherwise, you should watch TV tonight, tonight's TV. So, this real book made of gold. They use gold, they mail the gold and write this book, each character, character by character. And how many pages for this book? You can see this over here. This one, two, three, four, five, six pages. And this one, this also one page. This page, including diagram, is only one page. Okay, let's see some other diagram. You can see over here, another six pages, one page with two bigger diagram. This, all the yellow color are gold. Over here, you can see in Chinese, 龙藏经, how many chapter? 108 chapter. How many pages? Over here is one page, and this also one page. And the total this book is 100,000 pages. It's amazing, right? And how much gold they used? Do you know? Did you see when you watch the TV news?
They said that the price of the product was about $60,000.
Okay. They used 5,000 liang in another roughly about 300 kilogram. 300 to 500 kilogram gold. They mail it and write a character by character for this book. 100,000 pages. It's amazing. And you say about 60,000 US dollars. Let me see. 1.88 million AD dollars for a copy, official authorized copy only. So it's a priceless for this book. So it's a national treasure. Okay, what we can see here, it's a one page, another one page, and one page. Let me see. What? It's a. It write about some. I think it's a Buddhist book, religion. Religion book. For I think some. It's a kind of a religion related book. And they say if you see the real one, original copy, you can make. Some good luck for. If you see what this original copy, you can have a good luck for seven lives, for a seven generation. Your generation, maybe your son or daughter, and your grandson or granddaughter, second generation. Okay. So, and some staff are in National Palace Museum. We have a digital archive, right? And they give the digital copy to some people to make an illegal duplicate. The authorized duplicate book is at 1.8 million $80. But they gave the image to some illegal use, some people in mainland China. And the price is only 10%. Yeah, only 100,000 NT dollars only. Try to watch tonight's TV news. Or you are going to see many related message. It's a Long Changjing real book. Okay, let's watch this video. It's a MM, Nano Magic. You want to see in Chinese or English or Japanese? Japanese? we made it in three different languages. I think we should watch in English. Okay. Did you play this one before in Taipei World Trade Center? Roll down the voice. Okay. Key in the name. Okay. First question. Who knows the answer? Newton? No? Edison? No? Okay. Feynman. Yeah, he's a physics professor in physics. Yeah, okay. Okay. I think he's a professor in Harvard or Stanford University.
Okay, in this video, you can see several games. Let's go to the first one. Magic book. Nanotech magic book. Okay, there's one book. In Chinese, 奈米 魔法书, in English, Nanotech magic book. There are 10 topics. Okay. The first topic is space laser. Let's watch this one.
Wow, a space butter! Does the wire come all the way out of space? My book! Did you want to give it a try? Yes, please! What a fun! And now, here I come! Oh, does this wire really go all the way out of space? Oh, this is not just a butter! Look, come with me!Is this router safe? Will it fall apart? No problem. This router is made of nano graphite. Its weight is only 1/6 of steel, but it's 100 times stronger. Nano graphite is lighter, tougher, highly heat conductive, and unbreakable.
Herman, let's take the router to outer space.
Nano router, happy go!
Actually, it's a topic concerning nanotube, carbon nanotube. It's very strong and very light, so you can have a very, very long laser, maybe sometime later, maybe after 10 years, 20 years, we can have a space laser, so we don't need a space rocket. Okay, let's go to a second story, nanocapsule.And total, there are 10, 10 topics. Okay, let's watch this one.
What? Nanotechnology can make an airplane invisible? Yeah, let us show you how the magic works to make airplanes invisible.
Sure, show me right now, please.
Nano, nano, here I come. When an airplane is coated with nano paint, radar cannot detect the airplane.That's why the airplane seems to disappear. We just can't see it.
Oh, how come radar cannot detect an airplane coated with nanopaint?
Nanomaterial absorbs electromagnetic waves. That's why radar cannot detect the signals of electromagnetic waves, and enemies cannot locate the airplane.
Oh, so that's how it works.
You got it. You're really smart.
Okay, several other magic disc, magic CD, pigeon finding way home is that kind of like a campus, a climber, like a Spiderman, bathroom material, okay, yeah, maybe we can go, let's watch another different topic.Okay. Let's watch super doctor sleep. One experiment. In this part, there are four different experiment. Let's see this one. Butterfly.
Do you want to see the wings of a butterfly?
Butterfly wings?
Yes, let's take a look. Can you see the difference between the butterfly wings colors and the colors that you drew? Super Doctor's Lab, here we go. These are the original colors of the butterfly's wings.
It's beautiful.
And these are the colors on the drawings. Look carefully, they are quite different. The blue color on the wings of the butterfly glitters and looks bright and dazzling. It even changes color when you turn it round and round. But the colors on your drawings do not shine, and they don't change either. Do you want to know why the colors on the butterfly's wings change?
Anybody know the answer? Actually, it's a photonics. It's a nanometer size, or so-called photonics. Okay, let's see the answer.
Let's zoom in on the butterfly wings. Larger, larger, and larger. Wow! Butterfly wings have many scales, and these scales are covered with countless nanostructures that look like Christmas trees. When light shines on them, they reflect light in different ways. Change colors as you watch them from different positions. You know what? Beetles change their colors in the same way as butterflies. But not all butterfly wings change colors. Only some butterfly wings glitter and change under light. Taiwan exported lots of butterfly specimens in the 1940s and 50s, and Taiwan earned the name The Kingdom of Butterflies. Super Doctor's Lab. Bingo!
Okay, actually, there are three more. Besides butterfly, lotus effect, like shell, color, and some breathing while. Yeah, maybe you can play maybe later. Okay, so we today's class. So see you next week at 3:30.